Hi everyone and welcome back. Let's talk about routing more. So in recent videos we talked about the path-based routing where we are just creating the files into the pages, that is becoming the routes, and we were also able to manage the nested routes and dynamic routes with the help of that. So we were using nextlink and nextrouter. With the nextrouter we used useRouter and withRouter as a higher order component and as a hook, I can say. And with the help of router.query, we are able to access the query parameter. Now we talk about this shallow routing, router.push, how these are different. And we already talked about the API routes. In the pages in the API folder, you can create helloworld.js that will become an API endpoint, will act as a /API hello world. Okay, from that .js file, helloworld.js file, you can write custom code to respond to the server. I mean, you will be returning some JSON object with some status code. Okay, so let's talk about routing. Okay, so this is the basic example we have already covered. So what we are going to talk about is routing and all, right? So simple routing, which we have talked, is simple like this. So this pid.js, this can be inside a, you can say blog pid.js. Here we can see pid is a runtime argument we are getting. Okay, so pid will be able to capture. So this is the basic implementation of useRouter, and it will be able to handle all the routes which are coming with blog/any id. If you wanted to change it, and in the router.query, it will have the PID. This as a coming as an object where it will have a PID 123, whatever you are passing. And we also talked about the triple dot, which will be able to manage. It's like a wild card, you can say. Now, whatever you are sending after a blog, everything will come as an array in this PID. Okay, so PID will be an array of string, and then you can just join it that we have already seen. Now what all other methods we see? There is a router.push which we are using for simply navigating. Okay, so shallow routing, if I talk about this particular example, I mean, now we are using React, so you can actually do use hooks also. So here what we are doing is we got the router, and once the component is getting loaded, we are actually navigating to this another route, and we are passing router parameter as a 10. Okay, it is navigating to /. Okay, if it is like post or some other route. So in query we are sending counter is a 10, right? So router.query.counter, it will give us the 10. So whenever the counter is getting changed, you can actually run this use effect, use state, all these hooks can also get added in your Next.js because it's all about React. Okay. So what we are this what shallow routing is doing is, here we are providing shallow. So what is this? Is this something new? So shallow routing allows you to change the URL without data fetching methods. So you will be able to move to that particular component post. But if you are having get server side props, get static props, get initial props method there, so those will not get executed. Those will get executed later. Okay. So whenever the navigation happens, you will get the query router. All these attributes you will be able to access because the router.query will change based on wherever you are navigating. So to enable the shallow routing, you can just provide a shallow true. So, and if you're not providing, then it is not a shallow routing, you are navigating there, and all these methods will get triggered to execute and get the data, like get static props, server side props, and get initial props. Okay, API routes. We have kind of already seen, you just create a file and deal with the API routes here. Okay, so what we will do is next we'll talk about, so this is all about routing. You can also use with router, use router. I will not repeat these things because these are same until unless you build one application. Currently I'm just going through these each and every aspects and making you familiar that this is how things happens with Next.js. Okay. So dynamic API routes also you can create, that is nothing but like in the APIs. So it is same thing in the APIs. You create one folder post API post, and then you can actually create PID.js. So it will act as the same. Here you have created a simple function for the routing, right? Here you are getting query from REST request, request.query.pid, and you are responding it the same. Okay, so it's like a dynamic API routes. Till now we were talking about nested dynamic routes. Now this is also API routes, doing nothing but in the API we change the folder structure, we are creating everything in the API, so that will be exposed as an REST API kind of. Okay, so this is how all the routes will get created, and the same principle also applies to this. If you wanted to just generate a dynamic API routes which will accept anything in the query, this will PID will become an array. Okay, same as the routes we have added for the components. Okay, now what we will do, we'll take a look on some of the advanced feature, which is like dynamic import. Okay, and customizing the app, customizing the server, customizing the error page, customizing the document page. Currently we are running everything on the next server. Have you ever thought like, can we use Express here? We can create a, so if we have a custom requirement of the API route, then Express will be doing two things. Express we will be using next, Express server we will be using, require Express and app, we'll get the instance of Express, then app.lation, right? But we will also be passing the next configuration to the Express server, so it will be able to launch our application. So we can actually, once we have a custom requirement of APIs, we can create, we can write a custom server logic. So that is one of the important aspect in our demo application. We will write custom server only. Okay, we'll talk about how you can do a dynamic import and how this static content optimization happening with the Next.js. So one thing which is important is, if you see a HTML component which is not using any kind of methods like get server side props, get initial props, right, that means you are not fetching any kind of data from particular data source. That can be created as a static template, so you don't need to be executing the code and rendering that template based on the request. So all the static optimization can happen on these set of kind of components. Okay, whenever you see these methods inside a component, Next.js will build it differently. Okay, thanks everyone. We'll talk about some advanced features and we'll move to demo applications.